What is a battery monitor? Where does it go? And why do you need one? Well, clearing up the confusions between battery monitoring and their purpose in the system is exactly what we're going to cover today in lesson number one of this battery monitoring playlist. My name is Nate, and welcome to the EXPLORIST Life Mobile, Marine, and Off-Grid Electrical Academy. Let's get started. What is the purpose of a battery monitor and why is it important? So a battery monitor in your off-grid electrical system is telling you all of the vitals of your actual batteries. So it's telling you how much power is remaining in your batteries. It's calculating how much time is left until the batteries are empty or full. It's telling you how many amps or watts is going into the batteries or out of the batteries, depending on if it's being, you know, charged or discharged. It's telling you the voltages of the batteries. It's just giving you all kinds of data about the batteries. Now, on certain battery monitors, Victron battery monitors in particular, they even have some useful historical data. So you can go back and look and see, you know, what's the deepest that the batteries have been discharged, or how many cycles have these batteries gone through, or all kinds of really cool stuff that you can, just the data that you need to really understand the health of your batteries and their own states. Now, is a battery monitor necessary? We get emails all the time asking that question because, you know, these are anywhere from, you know, $100 to, let's call it $250, depending on sort of the model of battery monitor. And although it's not necessary, it would be sort of like driving a truck without a fuel gauge or a speedometer or a tachometer or anything like that. Like, you just wouldn't know how fast you're going. You don't know if you're almost out of gas and stuff like that. Is the truck going to run? Yeah, it'll still run. But you just won't know anything about, you know, those kind of vital things to operating, you know, the truck or the batteries in that sort of analogy. And so even though it's not necessarily like required for a system to work, it's really not a good idea to go without one. So what is the difference between a $100 battery monitor and a $10 battery monitor? So there's sort of two different battery monitor, theories out there. There's a shunt-based battery monitor, which is like this, which we'll talk about the actual shunt part here in a second. And the other battery monitor is just a voltage sensing battery monitor. Now, voltage sensing battery monitors have been around forever, and they've always been sort of the go-to battery monitor that you just connect it to the battery and it senses the voltage of the battery, and then it gives a quick, it's really not even a calculation, it's more of just a reference to how empty or full the battery is based on the voltage of the battery. Now, with lead acid batteries and AGM batteries, these were fine actually, like most of the time they worked pretty good because lead acid and AGM batteries, as they get more empty, their voltage drops until, you know, basically there's no more usable power left in the battery. And as you recharge the battery, the voltage climbs back up, and there's a nice, nice curve of what the voltage is compared to the state of charge of the battery, or how empty or how full the battery is. Now, with lithium batteries, they don't work that well in that same regard. And so it's real hard to measure those with a voltage sensing battery monitor, because with lithium batteries, you know, if it's fully charged at, let's say, a resting voltage of 13.6 volts, you know, 13.6 volts may be 100% full. 80% full may also be 13.6 volts. 60% full could be like 13.55 volts. The point is the voltage doesn't fall quite as much on a lithium battery as it does in a lead acid or AGM battery. And it makes that method of calculating the percentage of power left in the battery significantly more difficult, which almost really doesn't even work very good. So these are a little bit more expensive than the voltage sensing ones, just because these are a little bit more complex. There's a little computer board inside of them. And this is the shunt-based one. The voltage sensing ones are usually, you know, $10 to $20 or something like that. And that's kind of why. What is the difference between state of charge and depth of discharge? So any battery monitor, whether it's a shunt-based battery monitor or a voltage-based battery monitor, it's going to give you sort of two pieces of information. One is the state of charge, and the other is the depth of discharge. And I got called out on a previous video because I swapped those two around. And the thing is they're kind of the same. but they're exactly the opposite. So the state of charge, if you have 100% state of charge, that means your battery is 100% full. If you have 100% depth of discharge, that means you have discharged your batteries to a depth of 100%. So it's totally empty. So if you sort of use your context clues on like what somebody's talking about on state of charge versus depth of discharge, you know, you can kind of figure out which is which. Usually whenever I'm talking about anything on this, if I say a battery's at 70%, I'm always saying it's at 70% full. I really don't see a reason to say, oh, my batteries are 70% empty. That's just sort of not how we talk about like fuel in the fuel tank, if you will. So what is a shunt? Now I've said the word shunt a couple times in this video already, but this part right here is a shunt. And it's got these little pieces, you know, whatever, pieces of metal that go between these two terminals. And, you know, how this works isn't really all that important. All we need to know is that this shunt is going to measure the electrical information coming from this terminal to this terminal, and the computer board that's inside of here is going to take that information, compile it, and then it's going to give it to us as something like useful. And this is simply the device. This is actually the shunt, and then this is the computer board that the shunt is attached to. There's all kinds of different battery monitors out there. There's, you know, this one is the Victron Energy Smart Shunt. Victron has a BMV 712 shunt, which doesn't have this on the front of it. It has a much smaller computer board with an external display. Red Arc, they have their own shunt, and it looks pretty similar to a degree. Different computer board on the front. Midnight Solar, they have their own shunt with their own computer board. The point is this part back here is the shunt and is what's actually responsible for measuring the information that's going from one terminal to the next. How does a shunt work? So a shunt is always going to be wired in line in the wire that gets going from the battery bank to quite literally everything else in the rest of the system. So if you have a battery bank, you know, you can look at our wiring diagrams at shunt-based.life to sort of see this as an example. We'll pop some up right here as a graphic, but you can see that the shunt is installed in between the batteries and all of the loads and all of the chargers. And this shunt sits on that line, and it's basically counting how many amps are coming into the battery, how many amps are leaving the battery, what the voltage of the battery is. And it knows that because you've got two markings on the top. One is two system minus, and the other one is two battery minus. And so the battery side goes to the batteries, and the system minus goes to all of the rest of the system. So if it's a battery, it goes on this side. If it's not a battery, it goes on this side. And that is so these little fins right here can tell this computer board, you know, how much power is going from one side to the other. How does a shunt display its data? So a shunt is going to be able to display its data a few different ways depending on which specific shunt you have. So this specific shunt, the Victron Smart Shunt, is Bluetooth capable, and it's going to sync up with the Victron Connect app. You get it set on demo mode so it actually shows something. And so it's going to show information from the shunt that is just being, you know, Bluetooth broadcast over to my phone. You know, it's only got a range of, let's call it, you know, 10 to 50 feet. I'm sure we could see that on the data sheet, but you know, ultimately it's standard Bluetooth range, so you have to be like pretty close for you, you know, to be able to connect up to it. The other thing is with the Victron Servo GX or the Victron eChrono GX like I have here. And then this is just basically a computer here with a touch screen on the front. And this is Victron's sort of like central monitoring hub. It's sort of more of a more advanced monitoring device where we can log in remotely from anywhere in the world. As long as this has Wi-Fi, we can connect to this and anything connected to this. And this would be hardwired to this shunt. Now we have a lot of people ask, well, can I just use the eChrono GX and it's going to monitor my battery? And the answer is, sort of not really, not unless you have batteries with internal monitoring capabilities, which we'll talk about that later. But if you have a shunt in the system, you sort of have to have that because something like a shunt has to be telling the eChrono GX or the Servo GX what that battery capacity is. If you think about this like a vehicle, this is the sending unit that's down in the fuel tank of the vehicle. And then this is what's, you know, up on the dash with your speedometer and your tachometer and your fuel gauge and all that kind of stuff. This has to be in place in order to tell this how full or empty the battery is. So what's the difference between a shunt and a battery that has internal monitoring? So nowadays, there's a lot of batteries on the market, like this SOK batteries and a whole lot other that we're going to talk about in the next video, that they have internal battery monitoring, which does it make the shunt obsolete? Not really, because, you know, this is one brand and Victron is a different brand. And so if you're trying to get this brand to communicate with this brand, you're sort of at the mercy of different firmware updates. And most of the time it works just fine, but sometimes it doesn't work that fine. And so this is a nice safety fallback in the event that the firmware updates don't quite synchronize up. Now, if you've got a much smaller system and you're not using something like the Victron Servo GX or Echrono GX, and you just want to rely only on the internal monitoring of the battery as its own standalone sort of monitor that doesn't, like, you know, necessarily talk to the other, like, solar charge controllers in the system, something like this is totally fine. So in the next video of this academy, we're actually going to pull most/all of the batteries that we sell in our store, shop.explorist.life, and I'm going to show you sort of the capabilities of each of the battery types and how they communicate with the various apps, as well as the batteries that will communicate with Victron equipment like the Servo GX or Echrono GX. So go ahead and click up here to watch, and I'll see you over there.